Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. This is our third part in how to create an invoice that's going to auto-increment when we open it. In the last two netcasts, we learned how to get an invoice from Office Online and then how to save it as a template. Now, I'm going to record a very simple macro here that's going to go through the process of opening that template. So, Tools, Macro, Record New Macro. Notice that I'm in a brand new workbook. I'm going to store the macro in that workbook. I'll call it New Invoice. Click OK. And the macro is going to be very simple. We're just going to go through and do File, New, Templates on my computer. Actually, there's a recently used template from yesterday, so I'll choose invoice.xlt and click Stop Recording. Very simple, tiny little macro. If we go Alt F11 and take a look at the code, it ends up being basically just a one line bit of code. Now, let's see what we have open. We have two things open. We have the invoice file, and we also have our original workbook. And right here in our original workbook in cell A1, I'm going to put the next invoice number, so 1207, let's say, just as a guess. And we will come back here to our recorded code, and we'll say a couple of things. First of all, this invoice equals this workbook dot worksheets 1 dot cells 1, 1. I'm also going to add one to it. I'll just copy this reference equals this invoice plus 1, and then I want to save this workbook. Now, this workbook is a special name that refers to the workbook in which the code is running. So, this will make sure that we increment the invoice numbers every time. After we've opened the template, let's take a look back at the template, and we'll see that the invoice number is actually in cell B9. So, we can say cells 9, 2, B9 is the ninth row, second column, dot value equals this invoice. The other thing that I noticed about this invoice that was a little strange is up there in cell B8, they have a today function, which is great for putting in today's date. I'm recording this on April 14th. But what would be really nice is if I could hard code that date in that cell. So, I'm going to add another line of code, cells 8, 2, dot value equals date. Special keyword, reserved word. And basically, now what I want to do is anytime I want to create a new invoice, I want to run this macro. So, we're done recording, we'll close the invoice, and now it's just a simple matter of running new invoice, click run, and you see that the next invoice number, 1207, is added. We would fill in this data, save it, close it, file close, and then we want to run the macro again, Alt F8, choose new invoice, click run, and we get invoice 1208. So, every time we open this, we're going to get a brand new invoice with a brand new number. Okay, well, now we're almost there. Now, tomorrow, we'll take a look at how to take that code that we recorded and save it as an add-in, assign it to a shortcut key so that we can very easily and silently generate these new invoices. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.